During the early Cretaceous, 110 million years ago, the Washington, D.C. area was a swampy coastal plain crossed by river channels, some fast-moving, some slow. Scientists learned this by comparing the rocks and fossils from that time with the sediments and remains they find deposited in modern swamps and river channels.
The early Cretaceous fossils that we find in Maryland are preserved in sandstones and claystones. These formed when silts and muds and clays were deposited in swampy wetlands environments.
This Virginia wetland is an environment where plant and animal remains are being buried in fine sediment.
We're standing next to a channel in the wetlands. Usually channels move quickly and carry sand, but this one is moving very slowly, and that allows the silts and the clays to settle out. I'm going to show you a little bit of this mud. The clay is very dark gray, and you can see there are bits of leaf. They're very dark. All it would take for this plant material to become a fossil would be for it to remain deeply buried and undisturbed until the sediment becomes rock. This could take many thousands or even millions of years. Some of the fossils that we find in the Cretaceous of Maryland are buried in sandstones. And this tells us they were buried in channels where the water was moving quickly through the wetlands. Places like Huntley Meadows help scientists reconstruct the environments of the past. They teach us about the natural processes that went into making this ancient wetlands and help us understand how the fossils were preserved.